discussing very important example of problem representation. We have two jugs, 3 liter and 4 liter capacity. Now problem is to get exactly 2 liter water in 4 liter jug. There is no measuring marks on the jug. Now first we have to write the rules for the same problem, and then we will be making a prolog program for the same. Suppose X is the amount of water in 4 liter jug and Y is the amount of water in 3 liter jug. Now if suppose this condition is applicable, if X is less than 4, it means X has some space in which you can fill the water, then what we can do? Now in this case we can fill the first jug, will become the amount of water in that jug will become the 4 liter and the second jug will have Y amount of water. As a second rule, if the amount of water in second jug is less than 3, then we can fill the second jug. Similarly, the third example, if amount of water in first jug is greater than 0, then we can pour down all the water on ground, and as a result the amount of water in first jug will become 0 and second jug will be 3. And similarly, if the value of Y is greater than 0, then we can pour down all the water from the Y jug, and amount of water in first jug will remain the same X, and amount of water in second jug will become 0. Actually what we are doing, we are just writing down the rules for dealing with the jugs, or whatever we can do, we are just writing down all the rules which are applicable on a... Now next rule, if the total amount of water in both the jug altogether, if this amount is greater than or equal to 4 liter, then this amount is sufficient to fill the first jug, and as a result we can fill the first jug using this water, and the leftover water in the second jug will be the Y minus 4 minus X, because there was initially 4 minus X space empty in the jug, and this is the same amount of water which we can fill, we have filled in the X, and initial amount of water in Y jug was Y, so Y minus 4 minus X will be the leftover amount in the Y jug. Similarly we can write, if this is the initial amount of water and if the total amount of water is greater than and equal to 3 liter, then we have 3 liter water in the second jug, and in first jug the leftover water will be x minus 3 minus y. So this is the leftover water in the first jug. Next, now let us write the next rule. If x and y is the amount of water and the total amount of water is less than 4 liter, it means this amount of water is not sufficient to fill the first jug. If we fill in the first jug, the amount of water in the first jug will be X plus Y and the second jug will be 0. Similarly, if X plus Y is less than 3, the total amount of water is less than 3 liter, water cannot be used to fill the second jug, but this water can be filled in the second jug. Similarly, if any point of time we have 2 liter water in the first jug and 0 liter water in other jug, we can fill the second jug and empty the first jug. Similarly, if 0 is the amount of water in first jug and 2 is the amount of water in second jug, we can pour all the water in the second jug. So here we can see that there are rules, and we have just written the rules that can be applicable on different states of the problem. In problem representation, we are not interested to solve the problem, but we are just interested to write rules of the problem in a specific way so that they can be implemented in the system. This is actually our search space. We can easily see that if this amount of water is given to us, then what we can do after this? Suppose this is the initial state we are given. 2 liter water was 2 liter water is given in first jug and 1 liter water is given in the second jug. Then what we can do? Suppose what we can do? We can apply this first rule because the value of x is less than 4. So after this, what we can get? We can get 4, 1, because after this, the 4 liter water will be there in first jug, and in the second jug, there is the same amount of water that we have initially taken. Why? 1. And second rule, y less than 3, this rule is also applicable. So after this, we will be having x amount of water, means 2 liter amount of water in the first jug, and second jug can be filled. Here we are filling the jug from external source because this is allowed in this problem. Similarly, we can apply x is greater than 0. Here in this condition, x is greater than 0, then we can empty jug. So this way we can say that from this state, initial state, we can have multiple options, and below this we again have multiple options to choose from. And this way we can construct the complete tree, and somewhere in this tree we will be having our goal state. Now problem is reduced in a search problem in which we have to search the goal state. Somewhere in this tree we will be having our goal state. Suppose this is our 2, 0 is the goal state, so target is to find this goal state. So somewhere in this tree we are having this state, and some procedure can be used to search this particular state in this tree. To search our goal state, we can use any algorithm. For example, we can use DFS, we can use BFS. Now let us write the prolog program for the same representation. We know that there are 4 sections: database, predicate, clauses and goal. First, we are writing the rules for the same problem, and this is written in clauses section. Remember, what was the first rule? State x comma y. In prolog we have to write in predicate form, that's why we are writing this rule. In general form we were just writing like this x, because we have to write in predicate form when we are dealing with the prolog, when we are writing program in prolog. What was the rule? State x comma y. If the amount of water in the first jug is less than 4 liter, then we can fill the first jug. Then what will be the state? State 4, and in the second jug the y amount of water. Second rule, state x comma y. If y is less than 3, then we can fill the second jug, and we are not changing the amount of water in first jug. Other rules, state x comma y. If amount of water in first jug is greater than 0, means this jug is not empty, then we can empty this jug by pouring all the water on ground. State, so the final the resultant amount of water in first jug will become 0, and y will be the leftover water in the second. State x comma y. If y is greater than 0, then state x comma 0. Write some more. Remember one more state. If total amount of water in both the jugs is greater than or equal to 4 liter, means this amount of water is sufficient to fill the first jug. So what will be the final state? state the total amount in first jug. So x plus y is the amount of water in the first jug, and in second jug we will be having leftover quantity y minus 4 minus x, as we have discussed earlier. Similarly for the other jug, state x comma y, if total amount of water is greater than equal to 3, state the leftover water in the first jug will be x minus y minus, sorry, x minus 3 minus y comma x plus y. Similarly, we can write some more rules. In the predicate section, we can define this state. Predicate state integer comma integer. Now let us consider about a problem, about a state which is given to us, for example 2, 0. Suppose we are given a goal 2, 0, state 2, 0. For achieving this goal, we can see that first rule is applicable. We can see that first rule is applicable in this state. So after this state we will be getting 4, after this state we will be getting 4 liter water in first jug, and y will be the leftover amount of water. So what does it mean? It means you are filling the first jug. After this, to meet this state, you can see when we have 4 liter water in first jug and y in the second jug. So we can see that this third rule is applicable, because x is greater than, it is 4 liter, so it is greater than 0. So what we are doing, we are emptying it, we are making it 0. But when we are making it 0, again this rule is applicable, because x is greater than, because x is less than 4, because it is x is 0 and x is less than 4. So we are again filling the jug, making it 4. We are repeating the same states. We are filling the jug, we are emptying the jug, filling the jug, emptying the jug. So we are stuck in this repetition. To avoid this, we can make some arrangement that if one state is achieved, then that state should not be repeated. So for that, we have to introduce one more thing, one more predicate in all the clauses, and that predicate is visited integer comma integer. So instead of writing like this, we have to write not visited, not visited 4 comma y. If this state is not visited, then only we will execute this state. State 4 comma y. But once we visit this state, we will assert this predicate visited 4 comma y in the knowledge base. Let's write this more clearly. State x comma y, x is less than 4, not visited 4 comma y, then assert it visited x comma y, state 4 comma y. So if this condition is achieved, and this state, this condition, if this condition is achieved and then 4 comma y is not visited before, then we are asserting visited x comma y. This state we are introducing in the knowledge base, and we are changing this state x comma y state into 4 comma y state. But 4 comma y state, as a result, if next time we are searching for this particular state, this statement will be false, because we have already inserted with x comma y. This predicate not visited 4 comma y will be false, and this state will not be repeated again. So this way we can write all the states. For example, let us write some more. State x comma y, if x is greater than 0, then not visited, what will be the final state in this case? 0 comma y comma, now we will be asserting this state, now visited x comma y state 0 comma y. We can write all the states. And there is another problem in this statement. State x comma y, if total amount of water is greater than equal to 4, not visited, if total amount of water is greater than or equal to 4, then we have left, what amount of water we have left over? Then what was the amount of water? Then what was the leftover amount of water in, now what was the leftover water in the second jug? It was y minus 4 minus x. But in a predicate we cannot write like this. So we have to introduce a new variable, z equal to y minus 4 minus x, and then we have to write not visited four comma z, assert visited x comma y comma state 4 comma z. So this rule will be written like this. Now in goal state, we can write the state which we want to achieve. And in clauses section also, we have to provide the initial state. Suppose this is the initial state we are providing, and we want to get this state. So this is the total program. First we are defining database. In this we have defined a predicate visited, integer integer, and in predicate we are defining state predicate, and after that we are having this clauses section. First we have given the initial values, and I explained that why you need to introduce these two predicates, visited and asserts. So this is the total problem representation in Prolog program.